Good morning, everybody. Conference chair, ladies and gentlemen. The topic of my research is IT registration system in Sri Lanka. Comparative study of Austria and Ghana. Land is a natural habitat of people. It plays a vital role in the economic process. It's a good asset. And the security of the land rights are crucial for an investment. So, the written evidence of land is very important. For that, the country needs to establish and maintain a systematically arranged title land registration system. Land registration is a form of recording information about the ownership of land. There are two common recognized creative systems of land registration. The first one is the deed registration system and the other one is the title registration system. The title registration system is considered as the most refined system of land registration in the world. In Sri Lanka, registration of deeds was proposed to be replaced with the registration of title system introduced by the Registration of Title Act No. 21 of 1998. Under this system, it is expected to have the certainty of ownership of land, which is guaranteed by the government, to avoid repeated examination of the past title and expected to minimize land disputes and forgeries and look forward for a dynamic land market in Sri Lanka. And it is expected to complete its title registration process within 15 years. Now look at this map. It shows the implementation of title registration in Sri Lanka in 2013. That is after 15 years of the introduction of this act. The yellow color areas show where title registration had been completed in 2013. And the blue color areas show where title registration was going on in 2013. And in other areas, title registration had not been started in 2013. So you can understand how slow this title registration was going on in Sri Lanka. Why? The reason is the inherent weaknesses in our title registration law. So, my objectives of the research is to identify issues prevailing with the implementation of Title Registration Act in Sri Lanka and to propose amendments. Weaknesses in Title Registration Act. Under this Act, the investigation of a title of a land is done by the Commissioner for Registration or a Conciliation Board appointed by the Commissioner. The problem is whether it will ensure a due and proper investigation. The second one. According to this Title Registration Act, the titles of the lands are categorized into two. The first one is the first class title and the second class title. Still, there is a confusion about the validity of these second class titles. And the third problem. The rights of the co-owners enjoying an undivided land are taken away by this act. And also this act does not avoid the necessity for repeated examination of the past titles, and this act is not strong enough to prevent frauds, reduce the cost of the parties for transactions, and does not create an efficient and effective land market in Sri Lanka. So I selected for my research the title registration law in Sri Lanka as the main unit of analysis and the title registration laws in Austria and also in Ghana as the other units of currency. Now the title registration in Austria. There is a very developed, effective system of title registration in that country. It gives a high level of security. And anyone can identify the present owner or the obligation or encumbrances or rights referring to the general civil law. And the system of registration is closely related to the cadastral map. Although the title, the cadastre and the land register work fully independently, they unify a common database. So all these information are open to public, and some official and institutions have online access to this database. This is the system of title registration. There are judiciaries involved in the title registration. So, in this system, every entry of change in the rights of the owners is done by the land courts. So, this is a joint effort of the judiciary and government officials. Now, we see the situation in Ghana. In Ghana, there are customary roads and, in Ghana, there are customary lands and public lands. And the land in the system is based on unwritten customary laws. The customary lands are owned by communities such as roads, schools, schemes, communities of land. Ownership of the customary lands are rooted in trustships and fiduciary principles. In the title registration process in this country is done by the government official and private practitioners, but not the judiciary. So many problematic areas are arising in Ghana when the title registration is implemented. When a transaction is done and need to register, most of the time the paramount registration has not been done. This is a major problem in Ghana system, and weaknesses in the law, institutional failures, lack of information of land and unawareness have been identified as the major causes of the failure in the title registration system in Ghana. I did a cross analysis about the laws in Sri Lanka, Austria and Ghana. I discussed these matters in detail. Then after the cross analysis, I found what affects the implementation of title registration. The reason. Prevailing customer laws in the country. There is a cooperation between the cadastre and the registration, and judicial intervention of land registration. Prevailing customary laws in the country. When in a country customary laws are prevailing, most of the time it differs from the statutory law about the land in the same country. In Ghana experience, the land title registration act aims at solving the problems of the overriding land tenure. The substantive laws are not changed, so the issues remain unsolved. In Sri Lankan situation, we also face a similar situation. We have different types of law and different law based on the industry. Under these laws, succession of land rights are usual. But in Austria, they have developed a land rights system with law customary laws and same law prevails throughout the country. The cooperation between the cadastre and the registration is crucial for dynamic land registration. In Australia, they cooperate very well, but in Ghana and Sri Lanka, the cooperation is very weak. The judicial intervention of the land rights. Austria has a very satisfactory intervention of judiciary in title registration. But Ghana, no judicial intervention, and the Sri Lankan situation, by this act, the Registration of Land Act, deciding the title and the legal work, has given away from the professionals and given to the government officials. This is the major setback I see in this Act. So my recommendations to the Right to Education Act. Introducing amendments to the adjudication procedure, the power of the deciding authority should be given to the judiciary. Then most of these problems could be solved. The undivided problems of clans can taken away by the end of the co-ownership, and the problem of second class IP will not arise. Amendments must be introduced to remove the provisions of the co-ownership, or suitable provisions must be introduced. And new legal reforms and land tenure must be brought to establish a uniform system about the land tenure instead of varying more provisions should be introduced to defeat the fraudulent transfers. And as a conclusion, necessary amendments must be done before implementing this Act. Otherwise, it will be a money and time wasting process without benefit. And there will be a big problem for civil courts, resulting in risk of litigation. So I conclude my presentation. Thank you very much for your kind cooperation.